Joining us on Houston Sports Talk is Texans defensive end Jeffrey Pagan. And first year as a rookie in the NFL, what's it been like for you so far? How have you felt like you've done as far as adjusting to the NFL?
Well, the NFL has been, you know, definitely, you know, a change from college. It's been very exciting. You know, I've met, you know, some great players, and I've been able to compete with some of the best players in the world. And really, it's just a blessing that I'm here, and I'm just trying to, you know, be a good teammate to everybody and play my role, especially this being my first year.
What is it like to be around a guy like J.J. Watt on a regular basis for a rookie defensive end? I mean, what does it mean to have a guy like him to kind of look over towards on the other side of the line?
Well, he definitely, you know, sets the bar. He sets the standard, you know, for how, you know, everyone should work, you know. So I try to stay as close to him as I can on the practice field and try to learn from him. I ask him questions and things like that. But having a guy like that to be able to help me just only helps benefit me in the long run.
Is there stuff that he's doing out there that you just are a little bit amazed as you watch him play? Do you get surprised by anything he does?
Yeah, that's every game, you know, and even in practice. I mean, he does something every game that just makes me like – That just wows me, and not just me, but, you know, the world, you know. So he's definitely blessed, and, you know, his work ethic, you know, says a lot about, you know, why he's so successful.
You played at Alabama, a legendary program with Nick Saban. What does it mean to play in that program, to come from there to the NFL? How prepared were you coming from Alabama, and how much does it help to come from a program like that?
Well, the program in Alabama, you know, was definitely, you know, one of the best. It definitely prepared, you know, me for the speed, you know, the toughness, and, you know, all the things that come with playing in the NFL. It's definitely a different game here, and I have to learn from, you know, guys like J.J. Watt and Coach Kolar and Coach O'Brien, you know, the different techniques and things like that to be able to be a productive player in the NFL.
What can you tell us about Nick Saban, just being around him as a coach? Anything that maybe people wouldn't know about him just from seeing him on TV and hearing about Nick Saban? What is he like to play under?
He's a great guy to play under. He's about his business, and he knows how to win, you know. Outside of football, you know, he's a really funny guy. I don't know if a lot of people know that. He's definitely a business, you know, winning type coach, you know, and he's going to do whatever it takes, and he's going to play whoever it takes to win.
Do you and Kareem have a different sort of relationship just because of your history back with the Tide?
I mean, me and Kareem, we're cool. You know, we're definitely, you know the guys that everybody look at, especially, you know, come Saturdays when Alabama's playing, and there's a lot of Alabama haters out there. But, you know, me and Kareem just stick together. You know, that's my boy.
What's your dream, and as far as the NFL, what are your goals that you're kind of trying to set for yourself moving forward?
My goals are, well, for this year is just, you know, be the best teammate I can be, help contribute to the team, and play my role the best way I can.
What about Coach Kolar? Tell me what it's like to play with him and get coached by Coach Kolar.
Well, he definitely, you know, brings a lot of energy. You know, he's one of the best coaches, you know, in the league. You know, he's been doing it, you know, just about as long as anybody, and you know, he definitely, you know, holds us all to a high standard. So, you know, playing under him is only going to make me better.
You grew up in Asheville, you said. And who was your team there? And who were your players that you kind of looked up to, the team that you kind of followed? Was it NFL or was it more college?
Honestly, growing up, I really didn't, you know, follow too much. You know, I was one of those guys that was torn between basketball at the time. And I was more leaning towards basketball when I was, you know, growing up. But as I got older, I just kind of separated myself, and I started getting recruited in football. So then I decided to do something a little different and go with Alabama, which is something nobody has done from where I'm from.
Playing high school ball, what was your thinking as far as what you were going to do? Did you think you were going to be a defensive end, or did that come later on? What did you look to as far as going towards college and the NFL?
Going into college, I was being recruited to play outside linebacker, and I suffered a knee injury my senior year that made me gain a little weight. Coaches and different teams started recruiting me to play defensive end, so that's honestly where I wanted to play anyway. So I just took that as another obstacle and blessing, and I decided to play defensive end, and that's kind of what led me to where I am now.
Houston, Texas, had you been here before? Did you know anything about it?
I've never been here before, never visited, so this was all new when I got drafted here.
What about for the holidays? The holidays are coming up. Do you have plans with family coming in for the holidays and Thanksgiving?
I may have a couple family members in town, but I know that we're going to be preparing for a game, so that's really where my mind is, you know, just focusing on that week's game that's coming up.
That's Texas defensive end Jeffrey Pagan. Thanks a lot for joining us.
Thank you.